The Jews then disputed among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" So Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate and they died. But the one who eats this bread will live forever." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. The Lord of hosts comes and greets us, his children, with words of love and grace and peace. This particular piece of John's scripture gives us pause. To the Jews who heard it over 2,000 years ago, and today to the modern Christian, it sounds like we are cannibals, eating human flesh and drinking human blood. This piece of scripture also gave this pastor pause on Monday night. That's when I realized that this scripture lesson would not be preached like a normal Pastor Martha sermon. If you've ever been to our women's retreat, which probably counts out most of you men, you may have heard me say to my fellow pastors, Kay and Jenny and Carol, "I'm religious, but I'm not spiritual." Now, Pastor Kay and Jenny and Carol, they will tell you that they are spiritual, but they're not religious. Now, I know those sound like really funny things for a group of pastors to say, but our thoughts of how we see that lends to us how we each read the Bible, and of course, in turn, how we preach that to you. So when I read the gospel lesson for preaching, I search for how its essence, how its moral compass, or whatever it is that will lead us to either a better understanding of our faith, or how it will help us grow in our faith, or how it applies in our life as we walk the walk that Jesus taught us. Now, when my colleagues read the gospel or whatever scripture they're going to preach on, they see it as an inner body experience or something. And I'll be honest, I don't always understand. But in the spiritual realm is where I have found myself with this piece of gospel this morning. I'll be using vocabulary that I'm not greatly familiar with. I'm sharing abstract concepts that you might need to chew on so you can understand what I'm presenting. So here we go, Pastor Martha being spiritual and probably a little religious too. Communion, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, broken, shed, and given for us. Today we are presented with a very bold statement from our Lord. "For my flesh is true blood, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats me will live because I live." I know it's kind of gross imagery to say the least. In the eaten body and the blood drank, there is life. In the body of bread eaten, in the cup of wine drank at the Lord's table, there is life that spreads throughout our soul. It spreads throughout us in ways that allow the hair on your arm to stand on end because of an unexplainable excitement. Or it sends a message to calm our nerves and settles our hearts. And perhaps for some, there is a sense of well-being or tranquility, like when you hold a new baby. And then there's the act of holding out our hands and expecting to be fed. It's a humbling and beautiful experience all at the same time. There is a sense of awe as the bread, the body of our Lord, is placed in our cupped hands. And as the bread touches our flesh, and we receive it, and we eat it. Allow that soulful nourishment to enter the reaches of your very being. It's almost a surreal experience. The cup, the wine, the blood is offered. It comes to your lips, and it's bitter and it's sweet at the same time. The bitterness comes from our knowledge that our Lord's death was for us. And the sweet remains on our lips as we remember that only through Christ's death were we given everlasting life. Allow the bitter and the sweet to mingle together, to remain on your lips for the remembrance of God's love. The experience of receiving the body and blood can give us pause to find words that are adequate to describe the spiritual transformation that we begin to feel. As we feel the body of the bread fill our souls and the liquid of the wine encapsulate all that is in our being. It's hard to find the right words to express what that looks like, what that feels like, but I've had an experience in the medical world that kind of expresses what that transformation might look like. So, I don't know, maybe a year or two ago, I had an MRI done, and they told me it had to have contrasting dye put in it. Watch when they tell you that, it isn't pleasant. So the technician is preparing me for what's about to happen. She says the dye is going to begin to flow throughout the targeted area, and she said you may begin to feel warmth as the dye moves through you. And you may feel like you have to pee. You may feel like you have to throw up. But trust me, she says, it will all pass quickly, and then we'll begin your MRI. Okay. So, I felt the warmth go throughout my body. I definitely had the urge to pee, and more than an urge to throw up, because I did. Now, I'm not saying that communion is going to make you want to pee your pants or throw up, at least I hope not, but you feel these urges inside yourself. A sense of something that overcomes you that you don't have any real control over. It just hits you like the warmth of that dye. Perhaps it even envelops you in a way you can't explain. I say it's God's mystery filling us from the inside out. When you receive the bread and wine, I hope there are sensations that make you feel good and not nauseated. Christ's life is in the bread and wine. The body and the blood is like the dye I receive. It runs throughout your body. It ran from the tip of my head to the foremost parts of my toes. When I receive communion, it's nothing I can see. It's nothing that can be extrapolated in some blood test or found within an x-ray. There's a rush of life. It's the power of God's love for us, the grace and forgiveness that we are blessed with. When all this unexplained mystery of God comes rushing in to our mortal souls, into the spiritual holiness we have received in the taking of Christ's body, it gives us life. Life for the journey that we head straight out to as we walk out of this mission field and into the greater mission field of Rock Springs. Through this body and blood, we are fed. This is how our innermost being finds life. This is where and how our strength is grown when we need to find the strength to even put one foot in front of the other day after day. It gives us the strength to get out of bed one more day. The mystery of God that feeds our inner inmost.
Just for you. Amen.